So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB Current Affairs. And in this session, I will bring to you some more important questions from the PIB news, which are relevant for all the government exams. So let's begin with the session. But before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to the channel and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session after the session is completed. And you can also follow me here. Here also you can ask any doubt. So let's talk about the very first question, which says Union Cabinet has recently approved provisioning of mobile services in uncovered villages of aspirational districts across 5 states. So the question is, which of the following is not one of the 5 states jahan pe ye approval, jin states ke liye approval mila hai. Okay, so let's talk about the news first, then we will come back to the question. So the Union Cabinet has approved provisioning of mobile services in uncovered villages of aspirational districts across 5 states. And which are these 5 states? These are Andhra Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Maharashtra and Odisha. Do remember the name of these 5 states. And also remember that these villages belongs to aspirational districts in these 5 states. And in these villages, 4G based mobile services will be provided. 4G based mobile services will be provided and the number of aspirational districts here is 44. This approval is given for 44 aspirational districts across these 5 states. Alright. The total cost of implementation will be ₹6,466 crores and this funding, this amount will be provided by Universal Service Obligation Fund, which is maintained by Department of Telecommunication. Okay? Universal Service Obligation Fund is being maintained by Department of Telecommunication and it came into effect in the year 2002. 2002 se ye fund manage ho raha hai and this fund is provided for maintaining the telecommunication service and to spread the internet and telecommunication technologies across the country. And also remember to complete this project, 18 months have been given. All right. Now talking about USOF, Universal Service Obligation Fund. So the objective is to extend the telecom network and to stimulate the uptake of internet and communication technologies across the country. It came into force in the year 2002. And remember, it is a non-lapsable fund. Now, what is the meaning of non-lapsable fund? See, let's say ki 10,000 crore is allotted for the year 2021-22. Now, if out of this 10,000 crore, let's say 2,000 crore remains unused. So, kya hoga? Kya ye fund lapse ho jayega? No. This 2,000 crore, this remaining 2,000 crore will transfer to the next financial year 2022-23. So, it is a non-lapsable fund and it is generated by 5% universal service levy that is charged upon all the telecom fund operators on their adjusted gross revenue. ठीक है, जो telecom fund operators हैं उनके ऊपर 5% का universal service levy लगाया जाता है और वहाँ से ये fund generate होता है. And of course, the nodal authority for implementation for managing this fund is Department of Telecommunication under the Ministry of Communication in Government of India. Okay. So this was about this news and now let's come back to the question. So these 5 states are Andhra Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Maharashtra and Odisha. So Gujarat is not, Tamil Nadu is not among those 5 states. So option E, Tamil Nadu guys, is the correct answer. So I hope this question is clear. Moving ahead to question number 2. Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs, very very important question, has given its approval for continuation of PMGSY 1 and 2. Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana 1 and Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana 2. And of course, you should know that there is Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana Part 3 also. So, abhi tak total 3 phases aa chuke hain Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana ke. Up to dash for completion of balance road construction works under these schemes. Fill the gap. So, you have to tell in this question that up to which month or which year this PMGSY 1 and 2 has been extended or continued. So remember, PMGSY 1 and PMGSY 2 have been extended up to September 2022, and this ye dono ko isliye extend kiya gaya taki jo bhi bache hue kaam hai wo complete kar liye jaye. Theek hai, for completion of pending work under the scheme, this has been done. And there is one component under Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana, which is रोड कनेक्टिविटी प्रोजेक्ट फॉर लेफ्ट विंग एक्सट्रीमिज्म अफेक्टेड एरियाज, रोड कनेक्टिविटी प्रोजेक्ट फॉर LWE affected areas. This component has also been extended up to March 2023. ठीक है, March 2023 तक इसको extend किया जा चुका है. And of course, this has been done for completion of pending projects under the scheme. Now, I would not repeat PMGSY and two because PMGSY मैंने बहुत detail में कराया हुआ है कई बार. And if you want to know the details of Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana, there is a separate session for this scheme. You can search for Anuj Jindal Government Scheme. There is a playlist of all the important government schemes there. Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana वहाँ पे बहुत detail में आपको मिल जाए. Okay. So this was about this news, and here the question is regarding PMGSY 1 and 2. So these two schemes have been continued up to September 2022 to complete the pending projects under the scheme. Option A is the correct answer. Moving ahead, question number 3 पे चलते हैं. Which of the following organizations with support of Department of Science and Technology will organize Smart Tech India Initiative 2021, and this will be the second edition. This will be the second edition, and it will organize in the month of December this year. In the month of December 2021, it will be organized by SOCHM. It will be organized by SOCHM, and the support will be provided by Department of Science and Technology. And it was in news because recently Dr. Jitendra Singh has inaugurated the conference on second edition of Smart Tech India Initiative 2021. एक conference हुआ था, अभी Smart Tech India Initiative नहीं हुआ है, it will be conducted, it will be organized in the month of December this year. Okay, now, as I told you, it will be organized by SOCHM with the support of DST, and its objective is to celebrate, reward and recognize the spirit of innovation and provide a global platform to the Indian technology startups and MSMEs. All right. So therefore, the correct answer will be what, guys? SOCHM. SOCHM is the correct answer, option D. Moving ahead to question number 4. This is very basic question. Who has got the first prize in National Short Films Competition on ODF Plus under SBMG Phase 2? See, generally, main is type ke question nahi leta hun, but I have taken this question because this National Short Film Competition was under Swachh Bharat Mission Grameen Phase 2. So therefore, a question can be asked from this. Remember, top two prizes were given, and the first prize was given to Mr. Somnath back from West Bengal, and second prize was given to Mr. Lumlan Warjri from Meghalaya. So do remember both the names, Lumlan Warjri and Somnath Beg from West Bengal, and Lumnan Warjri is from Meghalaya. Okay, so here the question is regarding the first prize. So therefore, the correct answer will be what? Somnath Beg, okay, from West Bengal. Moving ahead to question number 5, which is the last question for today. With which ministry? Ministry of Animal Husbandry, Fisheries and Dairy Farming has signed an MOU for extension of benefits through convergence of various schemes of the two ministries. Ministry of Animal Husbandry, Fisheries and Dairy Farming is headed by Mr. Purushottam Rupala. Purushottam Rupala is the minister, and this MOU has been signed with Ministry of Food Processing Industry, which is headed by Mr. Pashupati Paras from Bihar. Alright, so option B is the correct answer to this question. Okay guys, so ye aaj jo news covering hai, these are till Friday. So uske baad ki jo bhi Friday ke afternoon ke baad jo bhi news hai, that I will cover in tomorrow session. Friday, Saturday, Sunday ki jo bhi news hongi, that I will cover in tomorrow session. And I'll see you on tomorrow Tuesday. ठीक है, Tuesday को भी session होगा, याद रखना. So thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care and God bless.